then point to note on the upper part before we start anything. This point say, for startup, maintenance, repair and modifying operation must be carried out according to safety norms and only by qualified and trained personnel. So, I think it's clear to almost everyone that I know most farms you have got your qualified personnel who do service for your tractors, for your generator you used to have before. So these personnel are the ones you should assign on the maintenance and the other repairs which needs to be done at the farm. That is after the handover and after the first survey. Do not start genset without protection or with the canopy doors open. With any information, contact based of technical team. So whenever you want to start your generator, make sure it's closed, and when you want to operate it, the protective the protections are there, like if you highlighted the head should be in position so that you won't cause any damage, or if anything happens, your generator will be empty and no damage will be done to the machine and also to the person who is operating it. So the first thing is the necessary checkups which need to be done before we start operating the generator. So we'll go on point number one. Genset visual checkups to check to ensure component integrity. We get out the visual checkups on the generator. That is, you open your generator, you check for any oil leaks, you check for any bolts and nuts which are not tightened, you check for your battery connections, terminals, you check just the general look of the generator before you start operating it. Then you check if it's positioned well. It's sitting on a horizontal position, not tilting it at one point, it might cause some problems as we go. So all those necessary checks should be done before you operate your generator.
Just one remark, as you will see here, the generator is on a small wagon, okay? So it's very important to keep it horizontal when you start it, okay? Because they move it from here to there, whatever, when you put it horizontal, very important.
Then number two, base frame. Check that both are securely tightened and vibration damping pads. On securing the generator, you need to make sure that it's secured properly. Because as you will be operating this vibration, it might move from where it's operating from to another point until it moves off the platform where it was positioned. So it's good to secure it properly on the position where it's working on. And it's got some pads where it is sitting on. Make sure those pads are there always so that it balances. It makes also easier for you to make sure that it's on horizontal position when they are sitting properly on those pads. Then on number three, on the engine, visual check of engine parts. That you need to check on the engine parts visually just to see if there are no screws or bolts which are loose. And remember, this should be done by a qualified personnel, because in some cases, if someone doesn't know about the generator, he might end up tightening what doesn't need to be tightened. So make sure it's by a qualified personnel. Then check oil level, check cooling liquid level.
Those things need to be checked before you run your generator.
then correct refueling of the fuel. Check that the fuel tank and the supply circuit of engine are not leaking. Whenever you fuel your tank, check if there is no leakage around the tank. Make sure that when you start your operation, because if there is any leakage, if there is a spark, you can start fire on the combustor. Number five, check for the battery connection. Check that there is no leaks and follow connection diagram. Like your battery is connected to the generator correctly, but it's mainly the responsibility of the technician and also the qualified person who is checking the battery. Check the terminals are connected well and the circuit is running accordingly, so that there's not an open circuit. Then check the alternator. Visual check of the alternator parts and of all connections to all terminals. So the technician or the operator has got a quite number of tasks here to check before any operation. Then electric panel. Check components, instruments, switches, 8-volt relay delay, device, protection and accessories. Just check on the electric panel. We'll see it when you go there, the electric panel. See if everything is in its position and everything is okay. Then also check on the earth rod if it's connected to the connected to the ground. Then there are other points to note below here. Number one, never start the engine in case of leakage, damage to parts or protection. For example, when you fuel your diesel, then you see that there's some leakage. Maybe you spill some diesel onto the base of the generator. Just make sure that you dry it before you start your diesel engine. If anything unusual is noticed, contact Petstop technical team. If there's anything, because on the panel there's some reports, it shows something. It displays maybe fuel low, maybe something it's reporting, or a red light which is showing. It means there's some problem. If you don't understand it, just contact the technical team from Petstop. They will assist you. Never approach this genset with heat sources or flames. Do not smoke nearby. Do not weld or grind while carrying out an inspection. Never approach the generator with naked flames. If the diesel catches fire or something happens, then it will be burned. Refuel genset when it is switched off and cooled. If you are spilled out of the fuel tank, immediately dry and clean the surface. So when you want to top up your fuel, please make sure you switch off the generator, then you top up your fuel, then you switch on later to avoid any problems. Any questions as you are going?
In the event that the pivot is stuck, how do you listen? Or the twist, how do you straighten it?
On the center pivot, when it's stuck, for example, as I told you earlier on, if one wheel is stuck, if it's stuck, the moment it's stuck, other wheels are continuing to move. That wheel will switch off the pivot. Because if those ones continue to move, the pivot will fall down. So there's a security measure which will then switch off the pivot. Then the pivot will stop. It means that that pivot needs to be realigned, so that it goes back into alignment again. Then our technician will go through how we are going to align it. Say that you reverse it, because for example you are going to right, then it goes but it twists a bit and it's bent like this, it will switch off. It's better maybe you have to pull back the other ways which have gone in front, then it is in alignment again. Then the tower check, tower security, it will show that it is in place now. Then you continue operating the keyboard. But we'll go through it, the process with the technician. Any other questions, or we continue?
Sorry, potassium. There's a function that you said when it reaches a point it might what mechanism do you put? Do you put a sensor or something? What do you do?
Yeah. On the tower, we'll show you on the tower, there's a ring which is round there on the tower. We'll then put a certain device which will sense on the turning of the pivot. As it says, was you said maybe 1 3/4. When it reaches that point where you set it, it will sort of like click, then it tell what that reach that point. And then if you have selected that, it will return when it then it will start returning. When if you have told the people that stop when you reach that point, then it will stop. So it's an additional component. It's not on this package, but it can be added easily. Just a small component you need to add on the pivot.
Yeah, but the issue is generally you don't want it directly to go back because you just finished to irrigate. So if it go back, it will stack. So anyway, you want it to wait. Okay.
Assuming that you are starting the generator and your pivot is on off position, that main switch is on, then you start your generator. Then you start your pivot. Then when you go again to disabling the generator or you want to stop the generator, there's a first warning here. Stopping the engine with load inserted damages the generating set and user system. So it means you don't stop the generator before you remove the load. Removing the load, it means you are operating, you want to stop your generator. You switch off the main switch of the center pivot, then you switch off the generator. If there are other loads which you have put again on that generator, you need to switch them off before you switch off the generator. Before stopping the engine, disconnect the load by switching off the magneto thermal switch. Then you switch off your generator. That it means you are just switching off the load, then your generator second. When disabling the generator number one, the engine is stopped when you turn the key on off position. So you have removed your load, what you do is just turn the key on off position. Then it means you have stopped your generator. But there are some cases where, for example, you turn the key off, but you find out that the generator is still running. Maybe there's some fault. Or there's an emergency which has just happened. There's an emergency stop button. There's a red button which you need to press if there's a problem. So number two, imagine stop. When there's an emergency and it is necessary to stop the unit, press the emergency stop button. So this is an emergency stop button. Even if, when you try to stop the engine or there's some problem somewhere, you try to turn off the key, but the generator is continues to run. You need to press the stop button. It will block the engine, so it will stop immediately. So in some cases, this is only in case of emergency, but normal procedure to stop the generator, switch the key off, and that's it. That is on operation of the generator, switching on and switching off. I don't know if there are any questions before we move to maintenance and inspection. A point to note on maintenance and inspection. Do not carry out or undertake maintenance and or operations or changes if you do not have the proper knowledge or you have not received precise instructions. As indicated earlier, we need a qualified personnel to carry out any maintenance or repairs on the machine. All operations must be carried out respecting security norms and by qualified personnel. So it means if that person is qualified, he knows the norms or he knows the do's and don'ts when you are maintaining this generator. But if there is something you don't understand, it's better you ask the technical team from PESTO who will help you. Before any check is done, make sure that suitable protective gear is worn as mentioned in this manual. Protective clothing. I know most of the farmers, you know about protective clothing, especially whenever you are doing any operation. Your protective clothing is crucial to avoid any damages. Then points to note on maintenance of the generator. Before carrying out any maintenance or inspection operation on the genset or installation, it is absolutely necessary to block the genset and turn it off. So what you need to do is, before you carry out any operations, turn it off, and if it's necessary, blocking it. It means by pressing that emergency stop, you are assured that there is no any circuit or any circuit which is alive, to avoid any damages. So it's better you turn off. In some cases, you can block it so that you do your operations without any problem. It is also necessary that the unit is disconnected from any connections to the mains preheating system, mains failure check system, battery charger, and anything else. If you want to do your operations or your maintenance, disconnect your generator to the load completely. Maybe you might need to remove the battery terminal so that you know that there is no electricity coming into the engine where you want to work it. It is advisable to turn the key on off position, then remove it from the panel is to guarantee maximum security. So I said, yeah, I want to turn it on off, then remove the key so that you are guaranteed that there is no another problem which is going to happen, especially on the electric part of it, where the battery is just a precaution to be more safer. If you stop, you press the emergency stop button, you are blocking the system out. You are sure that there is no another problem, like supply the circuit. You have closed the circuit for the battery, because the battery is supplying power to the engine. But if you block it, you are guaranteed that there is no electrical shock. are the checks which you need to do every day before you start your generator. You need to check your oil level, your coolant level, your fan belt if it's okay, your fan if it's in normal position, and your fuel, check the battery connections. All these things need to be done every day to make sure that you want everything. Check the fuel cartridge, the fuel filters, oil filters, and also change the oil on the first 100 hours. And where do you check? Partial engine overhaul 10,000, then total engine overhaul 20,000, then some bearings, alternator bearings 10,000 again, then coolant, replace coolant liquid 5,000, then replace exhaust silencer 10,000 hours. So this schedule needs to be followed so that you maintain the lifespan of your generator.